another story. Something to get off my chest. My life gets kinda boring. Need something that I can confess. Till on my sleeves I stained red from all the truth that I've said. Come by it honestly, I swear. Thought you saw me wink, no, I've been on the brink. So tell me what you want to hear. Something that'll light those ears. We're sick of all the insincere. So I'm gonna give all my secrets away. This time, don't need another perfect line. Don't care if critics ever jump in line. I'm gonna give all my secrets away. My God, amazing how we got this far. It's like we're chasing all those stars.
Good morning, South. Today is September 26th. I'm Megan.
And I'm Brittany, and this is your SRT show.
Brittany, I'm really liking your hat.
Thanks, I like yours too.
Wait, why are you wearing yours?
It's for Spirit Week. Hat Day is tomorrow, South. Don't forget.
Awesome. Let's check in with Student Council and see what else they have to say.
Hey, South. Hope everyone had fun dressing up for College Day today. Don't forget that tomorrow is Hat Day.
Wednesday is
Nerd Day.
Thursday is
Retro Day.
Throwback Thursday.
Friday is Purple Light Day.
So there you have it, South, our five Spirit Week days. The homecoming dance itself will be Friday, September 30th after the football game. The dance is semi-formal and tickets will be $5 at the door. Now here's some closing words from Michael Bauer.
Riddle me this, Bloomington South. What kind of room has no windows and no doors? A mushroom. Thank you very much, my fellow Panthers.
Wow, South. I hope you all dress up. I know I am.
Yeah, me too.
Hey, Megan, did you ever see the movie Transformers?
I have. Have you seen the second one?
Yeah, I didn't like it as good as the first one.
Me either. I feel like they tried way too hard.
Yeah. You know who else has an opinion about bad movie sequels?
No, who?
Mr. Fry. Let's hear what he has to say.
Good morning, Bloomington South. This is Mr. Fry again, back with the wildly successful Into the Frying Pan. Today we're going to talk about bad movie sequels and how they should be in the frying pan. Like Caddyshack 2. Caddyshack 1 was awesome, one of the funniest movies ever. And then they brought in Jackie Mason and did Caddyshack 2, and it was horrible. Caddyshack 1 was great because of Bill Murray and Ted Knight and Chevy Chase and all the great people. And then, you know, Chevy Chase has a cameo, Rodney Dangerfield. Chevy Chase has a cameo in the second one. Just wasn't as good. They ruined it. They ruined the Caddyshack franchise by producing Caddyshack 2. Okay? There are movies that they should make sequels of. You know, Harry Potter, they had to tell a story. That's fine. Lord of the Rings, they had to tell a story. They had to tell the whole story, and the movie couldn't be, you know, 28 hours long, or nobody would be able to get to watch it. Okay? But they should be doing sequels of other movies, like Spaceballs. There should totally be a Spaceballs 2. The first movie was great. The second movie can't miss. Okay? History of the World Part 1, at the end of it, they said there was going to be History of the World Part 2, and they never did it. Would have been awesome. So Spaceballs 2, History of the World Part 2, are sequels that should have been made. Okay? Caddyshack 2 shouldn't have been made. They should do Fletch Lives again, because Fletch Lives was awesome. Fletch was probably the best movie of all time. Okay? So if you haven't seen any of those movies, now you've got something to do this weekend. Okay? And our shout out is for Miss Simon and Mr. Jeffries and their excellent segments on the SRT show. Maybe someday they'll be as wildly successful as I am. So remember, South, stay out of the frying pan.
I haven't even seen Caddyshack.
Me either. Mr. Fry must be really old.
Our sports teams have been making lots of progress this past week.
Let's go to our sports reporter. Take it away, Daniel.
Thank you, Megan and Brittany. I'm Daniel here with this week's sports report. Girls golf team lost to Martinsville in prior to sectionals last Monday, with Hallie Peterson and Hannah Wright still showing us what they were made of. Then on Tuesday, our girls got shot down at the North Sectional in the midst of an onslaught of rain. The team is expected to have all clubs return for next season, and we wish them best of luck during the off season. The volleyball team, the girls gave it their everything in a match versus Pike, where they won 3-0. Great job, girls. They returned to action on Thursday in a Greenfield tournament. Hopefully they did well. But in any case, keep up the hard work. The boys' tennis team has been on a bit of a roller coaster recently. At the Homestead Invite, Ronnie took his match 3-0 while the rest of the team went down 2-1, although they still won, so they went up 2-1. In their last regular season match versus Center Grove, our boys lost 3-2, and the team played Pike on Thursday as a makeup game and swept them on senior night. Those honored for senior night are Patrick Holbrook, Eric Weidenbender, and Jorge Cortez. Good luck in the upcoming sectionals, boys, and as we hope to see more come from you. In football, the guys sold the Southport inside of Lucas Oil Stadium 35-28. The boys looked as though they were a completely different team in the first half, taking a first half lead, halftime lead. Though in the second half, Southport scored on 4 or 5 drives and took the victory. Coach Kennedy proclaimed to the HT that that's football. Kennedy shoveled up the offense once again, placing sophomore Joey Kreider in at quarterback. Kreider was incredibly productive for the team and even successfully pulled off a fake punt. The team will return home this Friday for homecoming. Good luck, guys, and remember, it takes a team to win a football game, not one person. In cross country, the boys got second at the Flash Rock Invitational. Good job, guys, and good luck in the rest of the season. In girls soccer, the girls gave up an early goal in the first 10 minutes and their loss to Evansville Modern Day, 3-1. The girls weren't ready to stop as Olivia Crow scored to make it a 1-point match in the second half. But in the final 5, Evansville closed the door and the girls lost. The girls also lost to Perry Meridian 4-1 last week. Good luck, ladies, in the rest of your season as you keep punting the ball. In boys soccer, the guys have been on a slide over the last week, splitting both of their games. They beat Martinsville 3-0 and lost a highly ranked Columbus North, placing them out of contention for the Conference Indiana title. And on Thursday, the boys were shut out by the Falcons of Perry Meridian. However, no matter what way the team goes, we will always look up to them as seasoned athletes. This week, the boys will be featured for their hard work they put in all season. And here we go. That's the end of this week's Sports Report. I'm Daniel. I'll see you in 2 weeks, and here we go. This is your South boys soccer team. All of the lights.
Lights. All of the lights.
Turn up the lights in here, baby. Extra bright, I want y'all to see this. Turn up the lights in here, baby.
Hi South, I'm Chase Neer here with soccer coach Kevin Sparks. So Sparks, how's your first year going?
It's been going real well. Boys have been working hard, and it's nice to show that all their hard work's been paying off. We're out to an 8-0 undefeated streak with 6 wins and 2 ties, and the boys have been performing real well, working hard every day at practice. In the games, the past 3 we played, we've had shutouts, 2 3-0 games and a 4-0, and as a coach, it's really good to see that the boys are doing real well.
So, Coach, what are your expectations for the year?
Well, at the beginning of the year, we got together and we discussed our goals and what we expected from this team. First one primarily was they wanted to beat North in the regular season. We were able to do that. Now their main thing is conference now. They want to be the first boys soccer team to win conference for the first time. And as of right now, they're undefeated. And we have 3 games left in conference, and if we can continue this, we will win conference, and the boys are very amped for that. And of course, as always, is a sectional championship.
It's spent that bread. I'm headed home. I'm almost there. I'm on my way. Headed up the stairs. To my surprise, replacing me. I had to take them to that ghetto university. Lights, flashlights, spotlights, strobe lights, street lights.
All of the lights, all of the lights.
Fast life, drug life, thug life, rock life, every night.
Chris Post is currently at 14 goals. Will he get his 20 goals?
I believe he will. He's developed the confidence early in the season with a lot of goals, and the boys have a lot of faith in him, and I believe he has the faith in himself that he's very confident he will be getting to 20 here by the end of the season.
Well, last thing, Coach, will you lead South to their first sectional in 15 years?
I believe we will. You know, I was a part of this team, you know, for 4 years as a player back in the early 2000s, and I know what it's like to lose all 4 years, and it's very frustrating. And these seniors especially, they have high expectations for themselves that they don't want to go another 0-4 years for them. So this is their year, and they believe it, and I believe it myself.
Well, South, that's all I have for you.
Turn up the lights, young baby. Extra bright, I want y'all to see this. Turn up the lights, young baby. You know what I mean. Want you to see everything. Want you to see all of the lights.
Make us proud.
Yeah, way to go, South.
We have a new segment on our show for you guys.
Oh, is it Simon Says?
No, but it's just as good. Take it away, Ashton and Austin.
Shake that.
Every day I'm shuffling.
Hey, I'm Austin.
And I'm Ashton.
And this is Austin and Ashton's Awesome Appearance.
So, this is our new segment about complete randomness.
Basically, we just find random things that we feel the need to share with you.
First of all, we will start with our word of the day, kakamimi.
It means ridiculous, pointless, or nonsensical.
Look it up. It's in the dictionary.
For example, our show is kakamimi.
So try and use it as much as you can. For the main event today, we will be talking about the one and only magnificent
fainting goats. Here's a scientist that can explain it to you. Take it away.
Yup, those are the famous fainting goats of Marshall County, Tennessee. Seems those goats get startled real easily and then they faint. Their owner says it doesn't hurt the animals. In fact, they're so popular that the county actually has a festival for them.
What happens is that when the goat is startled or excited, it causes a very temporary stiffening of the muscles. And when the muscles relax after a few seconds, the goat jumps up and runs on its way.
They don't call them fainting goats for nothing.
That's hilarious. It gets me every time.
I know, me too. Ashton and I became so interested in these goats that we went on a search and found a herd just like them in the atrium.
And now, folks, if you'll direct your attention towards the screen, you'll see these herd of animals in their natural habitat.
Well, South, we hope you enjoyed our segment full of cockamamie.
Let us know if you liked it.
We'll see you next time
on Austin and Ashton's Awesome Appearance.
What do you think, Brittany? I guess that means it's funny. I hope you guys like that, South. Thank you, Ashton and Austin.
Can't wait to see your next segment.
Well, South, that's all we have for you today.
Hope you enjoyed the show.
And remember, South, don't be a fainting goat.